to show you how you can easily make prepayments on purchase orders in Dynamics 365 Business Central. I have a purchase order that I previously created. From that, I'm going to create a prepayment invoice for the entire amount of the purchase. And then I'm going to make two payments on that invoice. And then we'll just receive and invoice that invoice as normal. So let's take a look at it. This is a purchase order that I previously entered. And what I want to do is make a prepayment on that. So what I'm going to do is go down to the bottom here. There's a quick tab that has prepayment information. And I'm going to put 100% in here. I can also do it by line if I want to, but I'm going to do it on the whole purchase order. And then I'm going to create a prepayment invoice from this. So what I want to do is put an invoice number that'll draw my attention to the fact that it's a prepayment. And then what I'll do is I'll go to Actions, Posting, create a prepayment invoice. So this does a couple of things. It'll put the status of the purchase order into pending prepayment. It will also create the prepayment invoice from which I can make payments on that. So let's take a look at the payments. Here's my payment journal, and I'm going to make a payment on that prepayment invoice. I've selected the vendor already, and we'll select the prepayment invoice. If I scroll down, you can see that this is the prepayment invoice. So I'm going to select that and set the applies to ID. Now my vendor wants a prepayment before they'll ship, but I'm going to pay half of that right now and then come back and pay the other half before the shipment is made. So on my payment journal, I'll go to the amount here, and I only want to pay about half of that. So I'll pay $16,000 on that. I'll print the check, and then I'll post the payment. If we go back to the purchase order, we can see the prepayment information. Here's the prepayment invoice. If I click down on the amount remaining, you can see that it hasn't closed out the prepayment yet. I still have an amount remaining. And if I drill down on that, I can see the actual payment that was made. So now what I want to do is I want to go back and make that second payment so the vendor will release the shipment and I can get the items. I'll go back to the payment journal to make that second payment. I find the prepayment here. I'll select that. Set the applies to ID, and I'll just go ahead and print a check for that. I'll post the check, and then I'll be done. Let's take a look at that purchase order one more time. Here's the purchase order. I can go look at the prepayment so we can see that. Here's a prepayment invoice. If I drill down the amount remaining, you see it's zero, and the prepayment has been closed. So let's drill down on that. We'll see the original invoice and then the two payments that I just made. When I receive the vendor shipment and the actual invoice, I can put the real invoice number in here. I'll just replace this, put in the vendor's invoice number, and then I can post it. I can receive the purchase order, come back and invoice it, or I'll just receive an invoice at the same time. I just showed you how easy it is to create prepayments on purchase orders in Dynamics 365 Business Central. I started with a purchase order I had created previously. I created the prepayment invoice, and then I made two payments from that invoice, and I received and invoiced that PO.